Hi, it's Jin.
And Bruce.
A lot of my subscribers requested this video, so here we are.
Here we go.
We are
Redolent!
We're greeting you once again with a new song and a new member as well. She's the youngest in terms of age and her debut. It's Yeri! She's the youngest in terms of age and her debut.
So Bruce?
Yes?
You're American, right?
Last time I checked.
Can you tell where she's from?
Not really.
I used to go to school in Canada first, in Brockville. I moved to Toronto, bigger city.
Yeah.
Then I moved to Minnesota, USA, where my sister lives.
Okay.
So she's from Canada. Can you tell?
Not really. Until she said the word Minnesota, which had a longer O.
Minnesota.
My friends who were on the east coast of Canada had a very similar accent to her, not too different from my own.
So we had some Canadian friends when we lived in Korea, and we found some differences between American accent and Canadian accent. So what are those?
In Canada? I found that people from the east coast had a milder accent, much like the Midwest, or as you head up north to Wisconsin and Minnesota area, they'd have a longer O, like a boat.
We're going to talk to you guys about the feeling of comfortable.
My friends from the west coast had a very thick accent. It was easier to distinguish that they were not from America.
Mm-hmm. And they also use different words at times, like they call a bathroom, like washroom, jewelry.
Oh yeah.
And how they spell is also different.
We spell color C-O-L-O-R, but my Canadian friends, they spell it C-O-L-O-U-R.
Or like center?
Yeah, they reverse that E and the R, and we say C-E-N-T-E-R, and they go C-E-N-T-R-E.
So they basically spell like British people?
Yes.
But our conclusion is, it's very hard to tell whether someone is from Canada or America unless we hear distinctive differences like a boat, or long O sound, or like washroom stuff.
They have different dialect at times.
Mm-hmm. But they are really similar.
Yes.
Tell us about your story.
When I first got to Korea, I spent most of my time with other foreign teachers like myself, and I found pretty quick there were not really many Americans around. I had mostly Canadian friends, and they would, from the first night, just talk about how much they hated Americans. So here's me, drinking my beer. And I didn't tell them where I was from until actually I was asked directly, where are you from? It actually took a couple weeks before they asked me, so I got lucky with that one. And by then, they already knew me. And they're like, oh, well, you're a good guy anyway. Like, thanks, man. Drink my beer.
Thank you for always giving all the love and support, especially for the Velvet album this time. And we'll be back as soon as possible. We'll try our best.
So when I first heard Wendy's English, I thought, man, I love her accent. Like, Korean people would kill for her accent. And when they think about their accent, they get jealous and depressed because they don't like their Korean accent. But as a native speaker, what do you think? Is it really important to pronounce like a native speaker?
If we can understand you, you're fine. I don't think it's important to speak or pronounce things like a native speaker because you're not a native speaker. So why try to imitate something you are not? Speak the way you speak. I don't speak Korean perfectly.
I don't speak English perfectly, but we have no problem communicating with each other.
That's correct.
We've been together for how many years?
Married or together?
Together.
13.
13 years. So if you enjoy this video, click like and subscribe.
And don't forget to click the bell for updates.
And we'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.